Let's take a look at sums with powers of integers. First, we have the sum of n integers. We can find the sum of the first n integers using the formula n times n plus 1 all over 2. Next, we can find the sum of consecutive squared integers using the formula n times the quantity n plus 1 times the quantity 2n plus 1 all over 6. Lastly, we have the formula for finding the sum of consecutive cubed integers, or n squared times n plus 1 squared, all over 4. Here, we are asked to calculate the sum of a polynomial. Let's first multiply the three factors. That gives us the sum of I cubed minus 2i squared minus 3i from I equals 1 to 10. We can now rewrite this using properties of sigma notation. So, we get the sum of I cubed from I equals 1 to 10 minus 2 times the sum of I squared from I equals 1 to 10 minus 3 times the sum of I from I equals 1 to 10. Now we can substitute into each of our formulas for the sum of I cubed, I squared, and I. So, we get 10 squared times the quantity 10 plus 1 squared all over 4 minus 2 times 10 times the quantity 10 plus 1 times the quantity 2 times 10 plus 1 all over 6 minus 3 times 10 times the quantity 10 plus 1 all over 2. Simplifying each of these terms, we get 3025 minus 770 minus 165. Finally, subtracting, we get 2090. So, the sum of the given polynomial from I equals 1 to 10 is equal to 2090.